dressed up to the brim. Said he just came down from a place called Highland Rim. Police said he came to ride the horse, the one they called the Brute. But he didn't look like a cowboy in his Continental suit. He stared at the way he dressed, but he never said a word. Walked on by the rest of us as if he hadn't heard. Walked up very slowly, put his hand up on the gate. We thought he was a purebred when he pulled a sack of dukes from the inside pocket of his Continental suit. Well, he rolled himself a quarry and he lit it standing there. Blew himself a smoker and he watched it disappear. We thought he must be crazy when he opened up the gate. Standing just inside was 1,500 pounds of weight. Buckton tried to run him down, but the stranger was too quick. He stepped aside and threw his arms around the horse's neck. Then he pulled himself up on the back of the horse they called the Brute. Seemed like he was born there in his Continental suit. The Brute's hind end was in the air, his front end on the ground. Kicking and a squealing trying to shake that stranger down. But the stranger didn't give an inch, he came to ride the Brute. Came to ride that buckskin in his Continental suit. Well, I turned around to look at Jim, but he was watching me. Said, I don't believe the crazy things I think I see. But I think I see the outlaw, the one they call the Brute. Ridden by a cowboy in a Continental suit. The Brute came to a standstill. Shame that he'd been roamed by some city cowboy in some Continental clothes. The stranger took his money and we don't know where he went. We don't know where he came from and we haven't seen it since. Moral of the story, never judge by what they wear. 'Cause underneath some ragged